Hello, Zenoviros, it's Svinsky here. You may have noticed a name change. That's just to, straighten up some ends because my Discord username was Zenoviros, Svinsky. Some of my other usernames were, so I just decided to change my YouTube name to Zenoviros, Svinsky. Anyway, what we have here is my first ever redstone contraption I made. It's an archery game. And all you have to do to start it is you put in a diamond. If you don't have a diamond in there, it won't start up the game. So you put in the diamond, you press the button, and you try to hit the target. Now you may notice that there's also pistons blocking you from hitting it. You've got to make sure you gotta be very lucky with your shots. You also have to hit it on a bullseye. It won't register if it's just on the rim or something. And I'll show you how that works later. So let's see, we got two diamonds. That means we hit the bullseye twice. If I hit it when it's at standstill, it won't deposit. I'll also show you how that works. So first off, when you insert the diamond, it sends a redstone signal, and that redstone signal will start up this hopper timer back here, and that will time how long your game lasts, which is just 32 stone. So that would be about 64 hopper ticks. I'm not sure how long that is though. Roughly, I guess, 30 seconds. Then what we have back here is the bullseye detector. What you do is when you hit this, it sends out a redstone signal, and how archery blocks work is that depending on how close you are, it'll send out a different signal. So you see here on the rim, sends out a low signal, and it's not getting through there. But if I put in a bullseye, it registers. And the way that works is we just have a lectern here that sends out a redstone signal through this comparator into this comparator, so the comparator here is comparing both of these signals. Next up we have the wind detector. So basically when the game is off, it won't detect when you've hit the bullseye. So if I were to hit that right now, let's see. You can see that piston moves down, and that would normally power this repeater. However, since this repeater is being locked, it won't send out a redstone signal. And when a redstone signal is sent through here, it tells the dropper to dispense a diamond into the barrel. And that's pretty much all that is. Actually, there's one other thing. When the game is on, it sends a redstone signal through here. That turns on this clock. And that just basically activates this piston feed tape system, which cycles all the archery targets around. Now, obviously, this could be a lot more compact, but give me a break here. This was my first ever redstone creation. This was the first thing I've ever designed myself with redstone. And yeah, that's kind of the design and story behind my, well, not exactly the story. The story behind this was I was making a Minecraft casino and I wanted something other than gambling machines in there. You may see that gambling table over there. That's a roulette wheel made by Rexstone. Anyway, I wanted something other than just straight up slot machines and stuff. So I wanted to make an archery game, but of course there's really bad odds. That's why the pistons are there. And I wanted to make something like that and put it in the casino, and I just wanted it to be made by myself. So that's kind of the story of why I made this machine. It also really got me into redstone. With that being said, I'm all out of time for this just short video. And you know what? I'll see you guys again later. So until then, tschüss.